Hey, what's going on, guys? Today I want to talk to you about something else that really grinds my gears, and that is Premium Bandai. There is nothing premium about Premium Bandai. What do I mean by that? When we think of premium, we think of higher quality, right? So we're expecting our Premium Bandai kits to not be so sticker heavy or not have so many seam lines or have better color separation compared to your standard release kits because we're paying a premium price for a premium project. But listen up, guys. What if I were to tell you that people in Japan speak a different language than English, and premium for us doesn't mean the same as premium how Bandai uses it? The point that I want to make in this video is that I think there's a big misunderstanding within the community with some people. I'm sure not with all that many, but it's something that I've seen more and more recently, that there seems to be a disconnect of what people think is premium and what Premium Bandai really is. And that, as I think, unfortunately, just due to Bandai's marketing and naming the line Premium Bandai, for us English speakers, premium does mean something that's like of a higher quality, or that's what we'd expect for a higher price. You're getting a higher quality item, that's premium for us. But unfortunately, that's not actually what Bandai means, I think, when they say Premium Bandai. Premium for them in Japan, as just a marketing word, simply just means limited, basically, for us. It just means that there's a limited supply of the product. It's not a product that's widely available to everyone, so it just has a more kind of special feeling to it because it's something limited. And that is another important thing to keep in mind as to why Bandai even makes Premium Bandai products, is because premium products or limited products in Japan are very popular. A lot of companies do it, a lot of companies make limited time items, and people buy them, a lot of people like collecting them. It's a big thing in Japan, so that's one thing to consider as to why Bandai does it so much, because if they're a Japanese company, that's a popular thing in Japan. But I can understand the thinking of some people saying like, well, hey, I'm paying a higher price, I'm usually paying, you know, two or three times the amount of the price for the kits, and so I expect something premium in the box. Well, that's what you're paying for the kit. That's not what Bandai's actually selling the kit for. The prices that Bandai sells Premium Bandai kits for is actually about the same as what they sell just their normal releases for. So like a Premium Bandai HG would cost like around 2,000 yen, and a standard release HG would also cost the same, around 2,000 yen. For the amount of plastic and whatever, stickers, decals, anything that's in the box, if you compare a standard release and a Premium Bandai kits where you basically have the same amount of stuff in the boxes, the price is the same, basically, in Japan. And I guess also in Korea and Hong Kong as well, too, where they also have P-Bandai. But that increase of price that you're paying for is not because of Bandai. Bandai's not charging a premium price for that. That increase in price, of course, is you're just paying to the proxy seller or whatever seller you end up getting it from. So people or companies that are buying it from Japan and then reselling it to you for a higher price. Now, obviously, I understand that sucks, having to pay more for items, so that will obviously, of course, increase the cost to you, the consumer. But I just think directing the ire of how much kits cost towards Bandai is kind of wrong. But then I guess you could also make the argument that, well, Bandai should just make the kits standard release, and then we don't have to buy the kits through different proxy sellers and stuff and pay much more for the kits. That's true, but the other thing is also important to consider is to why Bandai makes so many P-Bandai items, and there are some reasons for that. So number one, of course, the main reason is just going to be profit. Bandai makes a lot more profit off Premium Bandai kits, and at the end of the day, Bandai is a company, and the main motivating factor for any company is making money, right? So I don't think that Bandai is by any means this kind of monster greedy company that just wants to gobble up all the cash it can. I really don't think that that's the case in the case of Bandai. I think that Bandai is actually quite good in terms of being a company that does care about its products, does care about its customers, and does offer its products for a very reasonable price. So I think that Bandai products are very, very affordable considering compared to other different model companies and things like that. So just to quickly explain how Bandai makes so much more money off Premium Bandai items is because they cut out the middleman. So normally if they have a standard release kit, they have to sell that kit at a wholesale price to a store, and then that store sells it to you for whatever the price is. Let's just stick with the 2,000 yen example. Whereas if Bandai sells that kit directly to you, they can sell the kit for 2,000 yen and they get all the profits to themselves. They're not having to cut the price in order to sell that at wholesale to different stores and stuff. So Bandai just gets all of the profit back from the kit rather than just when they have a normal release, they just get a small portion of that. But even when they have standard release kits, they do make a ton of money off those just because they make so many more of them. So if they make 10 of a kit and get a large profit, or 100 of a kit and get a small profit, it ends up being kind of basically about the same. The other reason as to why Bandai makes premium Bandai kits is also to recoup costs for future projects or past projects. So if they make a kit that they put a bunch of money into, invested a bunch of money into, like say for example, the Perfect Grade Unleashed Gundam, which I'm sure cost a ton of money to develop that kit because it's a huge kit and it costs a lot of money to produce that kit, Bandai has to make that money back in order to kind of break even or whatever, or make profit, obviously. So they'll offset that by releasing a couple of P-Bandai kits. Or so, say for example, they have a big kit planned that they're working on in the future and they need to gather some funds for that in order to invest that into a whatever new big project that they're working on. And they're always working on new big projects. They also just recently built the 1-to-1 scale Gundam there in Yokohama. So, I mean, Bandai does make a lot of money, but they end up spending a lot of that money into development of kits and 1-to-1 scale Gundam and all sorts of different things as well too. So making and selling premium Bandai items is also a good way for Bandai to just boost their, I guess it's liquidity, I think is the word for that, though I'm not a business person, so I'm not sure if that's the right word that I mean for it, but you guys get what I mean. Anyway, at the end of the day, I get people's frustrations with P-Bandai. They're not always as easy to get. They end up costing a lot more for a lot of people, unfortunately. So I understand why there's a lot of hate towards P-Bandai out there in the community. I'm not going to say, hey, come on, don't hate premium Bandai. I understand, totally. But I think it's also just important for us, for you guys, and all of us to also just consider, you know, just keep in mind as to why Bandai makes them, why they cost what they do, and why they are in fact not premium as we often like to think of premium. There's no reason to think that premium Bandai has never been that. They've never been kits that have been marketed or ever made in a way that would lead anyone to believe that these kits are something that Bandai invests more into compared to their standard release kits. Sometimes that is the case. Like say, for example, with the recent Gundam Mark V Master Grade kit, I thought was a fantastic kit that they obviously invested a ton into. And it does feel very premium, but it just feels like a really good, nice, solid Master Grade, basically the same as what I would expect as if it were a standard release. So it didn't necessarily feel premium compared to what it would have been if it would not have been a P-Bandai item. You know what I mean? So that's really all I wanted to say in this video, guys. Hopefully that just kind of lays out some facts and important things to keep in mind for you guys. I think, you know, the best thing to do, if you really don't like P-Bandai items, the best thing you can do is vote with your wallet. Just don't buy them. Then Bandai knows that people aren't buying them. But of course, you just also, again, have to keep in mind that premium Bandai is probably sold this much outside of Japan and this much inside of Japan. So unless you can get like thousands and thousands of people within Japan to stop buying premium Bandai items, I don't think you're ever going to really make that much of a difference in terms of affecting Bandai's pocketbook enough to make them want to change their ways of premium Bandai. So I think premium Bandai is probably something that is here to stay. Bandai does continue to make a lot of premium Bandai and non-premium Bandai items, all of which are very good and very affordable items, I believe. And so I think Bandai does deserve a lot of credit as a company for the products that they make. And that said, I am also a huge believer in not worshipping any companies either. So I mean, if Bandai does do something that's kind of bad, or if they do put out products that I think are kind of less than average, I'll tell you guys. I won't sugarcoat anything for you guys. I think Bandai is a great company, but you know, they're not God or anything like that. So that's all I wanted to say in this video, guys. Let me know your thoughts and opinions down in the comment section below. Thank you so much for listening. Hopefully that helps to spread some good education or some good thoughts about the whole topic anyway. But for now, thank you so much for your support, liking the video, commenting, subscribing, all that's greatly appreciated. And of course, you guys can check out all the standard release non-premium Bandai items at USA Gundam Store. The link is, as always, down in the video description below. Check that out, and coupon code for you guys to use down there. Thank you so much. See you guys later. Bye-bye.